Notion recently held its first in-person conference and they unveiled some amazing new updates. It truly blew my mind how many new features they have added that are going to significantly improve Notion's usability and functionality. In this video, I'll be covering all the updates so that you can start applying these to your Notion workspaces and pages today. If you find this video helpful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. The first major update is Notion Forms, and this is such an exciting update because in the past, we've had to use other tools like Tally and Typeform to be able to add forms into Notion. Now it's possible to use forms straight inside of Notion in a seamless experience. So let's go over what this means. So in any Notion page, you can either click this form here or by typing /form to add a new form. And basically forms act similar to Notion databases. So you can also refer to them like a Notion database with its title as a linked view. So let's say that this one is a sample form and you can collect your responses here. So whenever you share this form, you can basically choose who can fill it out, share the link, and then they can fill it out and you'll see all the responses in here. There's also automation available. So there's a lot that can be done here as well. If you want to show a linked view of this database inside of here, you can simply type /linked view of database and look for new form. And you'll see that you can basically use this similar to how Notion databases work. So it's just a very seamless experience. You can go from collecting answers to manipulating that data through these linked views and things like that. The next major update is Notion Mail, and this is a super exciting update that's coming soon. So it's not quite out yet, but you can join the waitlist. And basically Notion Mail allows you to interact with your inbox in a different way than it's been traditionally. So that means that you don't necessarily see your inbox based on the dates, but based on categories, and you can kind of manipulate your email inbox similar to how you would with Notion databases. And as you can see, it provides a sort of cleaner look depending on what you're going for so that you're not looking at cluttered inboxes, but you can really set how you want to see your inbox. The other really exciting thing is that you can have AI inside of your inbox to help with things like scheduling follow-ups and things like that. And the other really exciting thing, especially for me, who sometimes it's really difficult to make sure to remember to use the correct name, especially if you're sending multiple emails with the same content, you can actually use these snippets so that you can do a one-click snippet and it's going to add the name, the company, and so on, so that you don't accidentally email someone with the wrong name. And finally, Notion has mentioned that they want to make sure that this email is faster than ever so that it's built for speed and it's beautiful and familiar at the same time. So I'm really excited to see what Notion Mail ends up being when they actually officially launch. But so far, what I've seen is very exciting and it could be a very big game changer in the sense that they're now having Notion Calendar, Notion, and then Notion Mail so that you can really stay inside of Notion and have this kind of seamless experience. So you might be wondering, when is this launching? Basically, if you join the waitlist, it should be out by beginning of 2025 for everyone. So stay tuned. Another major update is layouts. And this is especially exciting because we've been stuck with the same view for such a long time inside of databases. So let's go ahead and create a new database. And we can show you what this means. So basically, if I open one of these up, you can now see that there's an option to customize layout. So let's say that this is a new page. And if you wanted to add a new property here, and let's say that this is an image, so files and media. And then if you click here and you wanted to add some images, you'll notice that the image itself is very small until you kind of click it open. So what you can do now with this layout, along with a lot of other exciting things, is that you can actually click here and then add the files in media separately like this and apply it to all your pages. So now you can see it here as opposed to that very small square before. And you can also customize layout and do things like bring things into the side panel, apply to all pages. And then now if you click here to view details, you'll see these images on this side. So there's a lot you can do. And it's just nice that now you can actually hide some information through the side panel like this, especially when you have a lot of properties. So feel free to play around with this, and it could just be a very exciting way to see your Notion databases in a new light. Another exciting new feature is that you can now automate and send emails through Notion's automations. Automations are only available for Plus plan users and above, but basically if you wanted to automate to send emails, you can click this lightning bolt mark and then click plus new trigger. And you can, for example, if any property is edited, add a new action to send mail to, and then you can select an account. This makes automations a little bit more useful in the sense that you can now actually send actual notifications through email. So the next very exciting update is that you can add formulas into your database automations. And this is particularly useful because you can now do all kinds of things that was previously not possible. So for example, if we have the sample database, and let's say that this is kind of like a issue tracker, then we could click here a status. And basically when the status is done, we want to show like a custom message here, which shows when the issue was closed. So to do that, what we can do is to have a text property here, and we're going to call this issue closed. And you can do things by going to the lightning bolt here, new trigger. So basically when the status is set to done, then what we want to do is add a new action, which is going to edit the property, which is the issue closed. And we're going to click the edit as formula. So now what you can do is actually, for example, use a style property, and you can do issue was closed on. And then plus you could put the date triggered, and then you can do things like add bold, green, and then save. So now if we create this one, let's close this issue, and it should trigger an automatic thing, which is going to show that the issue was closed on at October 29th. So as you can see, this is way more custom than what was previously possible in terms of what kinds of things you could do with it. So this is quite exciting, and it's going to be very fun to play around with this. The next thing is the new Notion Marketplace. And this is very exciting because in the past, you only could buy templates through third-party sites. And of course, Notion did have its own template creator area where you can look for templates, but it wasn't a seamless experience. But now if you go to the sidebar, and let's say we go all the way down and we go to templates, then you'll notice that this is now Marketplace. And you can do things like look for templates here. And it's very good if you are worried if a template is not going to fit your needs and so on. At the same time, it protects creators because you can no longer duplicate templates and resell them, for example. So feel free to check it out. You can also find the organized notebook here. You can basically find all of the templates also available on Notion's Marketplace. So feel free to try it out. You do have a free refund policy in the case of Notion Marketplace, which allows you to try it out. But at the same time, if you do decide to return it, then you don't have access to the template anymore. So the next very exciting update are custom emojis. And this is something that everyone's been waiting for. So this is just such a fun update. So if we type slash emoji, and then we click the plus sign here, and then upload an image, then you can actually name this Totoro icon, something like this, and then save. And then if you wanted to add the emoji, you can simply type the emoji here, Totoro, and then you'll see Totoro here. So in that way, you can start adding custom emojis throughout your workspace, and everyone who's in your workspace can also access these. You can add icon here, and you can also do the same so that you can find them. The next exciting thing is that you can now set custom URLs in a way that you couldn't before. So if we go ahead and go to the share button, and then if you go to publish and then publish, you can now see here that you can actually create any kind of custom URL that you'd like and then save. So this makes everything look a lot cleaner than the previous option, which had a bunch of numbers. Finally, there's new shortcuts through the search feature to different kinds of Notion features. So if you typed controller command P, and then if we went to here and we wanted to see the templates, we can go ahead and click here. And you can also look for home, and then you can find home here. So in that sense, it's just a really useful feature that you can go to different places using the search feature. Final thing is not necessarily a current update, but something that Notion has mentioned during this live conference, and that is that they are working on offline mode. So this is a feature that's likely going to show up at some point, and they're really working on it. So this is really exciting, and it would just be such a game changer, especially for people who don't use Notion simply for the fact that it's not possible offline. So super excited for this, and hope that that gets launched relatively quickly. Thank you so much for watching. Which update is your favorite? If you're interested in purchasing templates from the new marketplace, be sure to check the link in the description. If you want to be on the Notion mail waitlist, the link is also below. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, and hope to see you all in the next video.